Hi friends, this is Professor Ripu Ranjan Sinha, Director General, Council for Sustainable Peace and Development, a promissory council for global innovation, peace and sustainable development, who is working in relation with the United Nations Sustainable Development Growth Agenda 2030, Uganda Development Agenda 2040, African Union Development Agenda 2063, and India Development Growth Index, India 75. So today I am discussing the topic about the sustainable development in sustainable, especially about the globalization, global change, the role of science in sustainable development, educational context, thematic link between the different subject and discipline to sustainable development, value and scientific understanding. This slide may be used according to the teachings need. Feel free to adapt a complaint by the society, because sustainable development is a link with the society, economy and environment. So what are the activities performed in the society? They are linked with the economy and they also affect the environment, and then if environment affect to the society, then so and so forth. So in this context, sustainable development is development that meet the need of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. That definition is the release by the World Commission on the Environment and Development 1987 report, Our Common Futures. So sustainable development is a development that meet the need of the present without compromising the ability of the future generation to meet their own needs. So in the case of sustainable development background concern, if the present growth trend in the world population, industrialization, pollution, food production and resource depletions continue unchanged, the limit to physical growth on this planet will be reached sometime within the next 100 years. The most probable result will be rather sudden and uncontrollable decline in the both population and industrial capacity. So in this context, if we are talking about the sustainable development during 1970 and 80, especially about the developing countries, international debate on the development crisis, that is called the debt crisis, and industrialization countries, especially international debates on the environment problem during 1990s, euphoria, optimism after the end of Cold War. Start on of the board perception of the global crisis, as well the earth as one system. Development of new global consciousness. A new world vision emerged. Environment and development problem are interlinked. Environment and development. Development debate and environment debate are united. So in this context, sustainable development is a long-term optimist model of the societal development and is centered around the people and their needs, skill and actions. So we are working at the Council for Sustainable Peace and Development for the people and their needs, skill and actions. The goal is in inter and intergenerational socio-culture and economic justice, while at the same time respecting the environmental limits of the natural resources. This task requires contribution at all level of decision making, from the individual to the local, regional, national, international and global levels. Correspondingly, wise participation is a core principle of this model. All actors should coordinate their concerns and objectives in their professional and private field of the actions according to the overarching vision. In this sense, sustainable development is a continuous process of negotiation of so-called trade-off, that is called the compromises, to balance diverse environment, socio-cultural and economy interest, and to settle conflict of the objective to the concessional and peaceful manner. The prerequisite for the negotiation is for all actors to be in possession of the necessary knowledge and the ability to act, or at least be enabled to act accordingly, in addition to stable institutional framework for conditions research and education are the key. So all the core of sustainable development lie global, societal, democratic search, learning, and setting focus. So in the case of search, we have to negotiate centralize, concentrating further developing vision and goal of the sustainable development. Learning part, continuous acquisitions of the reflections on the knowledge, skill, and competences, as well gathering and assessing experience. Shaping, transformation. For example, working out a concept and strategy, as well as implementing measure to promote sustainable development in all field of action. In a process like this, there is not only one sustainable development, but a number of possible paths towards sustainable development. This must be continuously assessed, negotiated, and adjusted to achieve the desired impact. So in the cases of effort toward the transparency and negotiation trade-off means that the subsequently dimensions are not always give equal in the case of societal, environment, and economy. Current generations, future generations, as per cases of that. So in the case of economy, society, and general, we have to face. But the thing is that we have the local infrastructure concern, past infrastructure concern, future infrastructure concern, and global infrastructure for the sustainable development, different weightage of the dimension. As per the case of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals concern, the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals is the 7th goal and 169 concurrent targets. So as per the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals of Sustainable Development Growth were approved on 29th September 2015 as in 2030 agenda for the sustainable development by the 119 member states of the United Nations. They have a broad global support and from the political wise for the effort towards sustainable development in the coming year. So the as per the goal concerned that is approved by the 25th November 2015 by the 119 UN member states, especially linked with the 17 goals and 169 concurrent target. Number one goals linked with the in poverty in all forms of everywhere. Second is the zero hunger, end hunger, achieve food security and improve nutrition and promote sustainable agriculture around the world. Third is the good health and well-being, ensure healthy life and promote well-being for the all at all ages. Link with the International Association of Sports and ICT, Council for Sustainable Development, Council for Sustainable Peace and Development has established a promising organization that is International Association of Sports and ICT at the good health and well-being promotions. Quality education, ensure inclusive and coordinated quality education, promote lifelong learning opportunity for all. Number five, link with the gender equality, achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. Number six, clean water and sanitation, ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. Number seven, affordable and green energy, ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable and modern energy for all. Number eight, decent work and economic growth, promote sustained, inclusive, and sustainable economic growth, full and productive employment, and decent work for all. Number nine, industry, innovation, and infrastructure. Build resilient infrastructures, promote inclusive and sustainable industrialization, and foster innovations. Number 10, reduce inequalities. Reduce income inequalities within the and among the country. Number 11, sustainable city and community. Make city and human settlement inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable. Number 12, responsible consumption and production. Ensure sustainable consumption and production pattern. Number 13, climate action. Take action, urgent action to combat climate change and its impact by the regulating emissions and promoting development in renewable energy. Life below water, conserve and sustainably use and ocean, seas and marine resource for the sustainable development. Life on land, protect, restore and promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystem, sustainability managed forecast combat desertifications and halt and reverse land degradation and halt biodiversity loss. Number 16, peace, justice and strength institutions. Promote peaceful and inclusive society for sustainable development. Provide access to the justice for all and build effective, accountable and inclusive institutions at all levels. Number 17, partnership for the goals. Strengthen the means of the implementation and revitalize the global partnership for the sustainable development. So in these cases, the global debate are there. Different safe and just space for humanity, regenerative and distributed economy, different fought for the sustainable development. Development are possible as long as they are conformed between planetary boundary and societary boundary as a ground rail. This ground rail must be negotiated. So in the cases of globalization, discussion on sustainable or non-sustainable effect of the globalization, global change, discussion on the cause and driver of the global change, as well as way of steering global change through sustainable development, or especially in the case of a sustainable development, is a discussion on the limiting risk and making use of opportunity that emerge from globalization and global change. That is a sustainable development. Link with the, especially the term globalization used in a particular in the social economy, human, culture, and science, in the analysis of translational process of the increasing spread of technology, innovation, regulation, interdependent in the business, society, culture, and politics, mobility of goods, service, and people. In this view, globalization occurs in the spatial distributions and network of the relationship and in the accelerations of the various trends and process in different social dimensions, with transient national regulation, transnationalization, and can be observed in the several regions or worldwide. Dimensions of the trade process, technological dimensions, economical dimensions, social dimension, cultural dimension, environmental dimension, political dimension, spatial dimension. A key characteristic, the various trade process in the different dimensions interact and only constitute collaboration through these regulations. The term global change used in particular in the environment and natural sciences and analysis of global environment change, just like a climate change, decrease in the biodiversity, desertification, soil degradation, ocean pollution, and fresh water security, and major drivers of environmental change like the population growth, urbanization, and use of fossil fuels. For this point of view, global change consists mainly of the global environment change, and the major driver of change, global change, is often also seen as a result of globalization process. In this study of the global change, a systematic and system dynamic view of the individual change, as well as interaction of the different change process with the global change driver, is often adopted. But in the case of ecological footprint and the Human Development Index are indicator for the sustainability of global development. Like the ecological footprint, it's the area in a hectare per person per year needed to sustainability continue current lifestyle and living standard. It is also include the area needed for the production of food, clothing, energy, waste disposal, and carbon subsidization. That is a global footprint index. The Human Development Index is a national welfare indicator which takes into account growth, national income, life expectancy, and expected years of schooling per year per head. That's for the United Nations Development Progress Reports. So in the case of significant reduction in the global economy, energy, and resource use only to achieve the industrialization to reduce the importance of the cases, you are saying the country like the Syrian violence to the USA, all country, the developing country, there is an urgent need to improve the socio-economic condition of life. Otherwise, situation will be very, very, very drastic. Global and social disparity are often the cause of violent conflict and migration. For chance cases, data source are there. So in the cases, especially we are talking about Switzerland concerned, then situation is very weak. So far, we have not succeeded in overcoming the global problem we face. This means business as usual approach as well as limiting ourselves in a minor adoption of such behavior change will not lead to sustainable development. That is why the scientific advisory board of the German Advisory Council on Global Change established. For example, it promising a social contract for the great transformation to tackle global mega trends such as the climate change or inability to reduce poverty, increased drinking water scarcity. So WBGU prostitute an urgent need of leap of technology, new warfare technology, multifaceted social and institutional innovation, and unprecedented level of international cooperation linked with the Council for Sustainable Peace and Development. So in the case of this, what the role can science play in the sustainable development? See, the pictures are there. Often research results indicate massive global problem ahead. What do the scientists do with these findings? To be habited entirely to the public policy maker and of other actor to interrupt our finding and work out solution, or do we take more responsibility ourselves? So the situation is that after the great researcher create and identify various problem, but who will create the solution? Scientists are able to solution, able to create the solution in the form of product. Scientists are working too hard to create the problem as per the research work submitted by the various professors across the world, but scientists are not playing very big role for the developing of the product, converting the product from the research paper to products. So in these cases of the society, social justice and conflict concern, intergenerational justice, environment growth and property, respect for the environment boundary, climate change and biodiversity losses, business that is environmentally and social capitalist. Overall, complex phenomena can only be explained through the multitude of biophysical, social culture and economy process which influences each other and whose link and dynamics are interlinked with the increasing globalization. So sustainable development required dealing with the complex society minor environment interrelation, that's the social ecological system which we try to understand while they continue change and are present dynamic. For example, intensive use and degradation of natural resource in the Ethiopian highland, which 80% of population depend on the livelihood, their resource protection measure must be simultaneously environment sound, economic viable and social compatible. Consequently, research into such complex society environment interrelation required interdisciplinary approach, concept and methods. So to research complex society and environment interrelation, social ecosystems, interdisciplinary cooperation between the various scientific disciplines or the fundamental importance. In addition, sustainable development requires that parts of the research be action-oriented, using a transdisciplinary approach, close cooperation between the science and society. The basis of their inter and interdisciplinary cooperation is well-grounded disciplined education for this to be or become relevant to the sustainable development. It is important to identify the connection between the discipline and sustainable development. But exercise chemists take the grounded model or the United Nations assessment to identify the between discipline and sustainable development. The two models reflect important debate of the development goals. Guiding question was that what thematic area offer your discipline relevant anchoring point? What are the topic of research actual and possible? What are the further sustainable development relevant topic that could be interesting for the discipline, but are not contained in either of the two models? What is the dimension of sustainable development? Environment, socioculture, economy, do your topic take into account, which occurs and other scientific discipline could be interesting partner for the collaborations? Is there a relations to practice? And if so, what does this consist of? So these handout, check it that this is a diagram, a drought model. You are able to see that where ecological ceiling are there, social foundation are there, and lots of climate change, vaccine acidification, chemical productions, nitrogen and phosphorus loading, fresh water withdrawal, land conservation, biodiversity loss, air pollution. So in the case of social foundation, we have to work out that is going to shortfall. Means this technology is going to cover short. If you are talking about the droughted model, within the droughted model, they divided the some concepts, some technologies and framework is going to divide it into two parts, that is overshoot or shortfall. So through the safe and just space for the community, regenerate and distribute economy. So in this context, Drungert model created the ocean acidification, very concerned, overshoot are there, chemical production, overshoot are there, nitrogen, phosphorus are loading, fresh water withdrawals, land conservation, biodiversity, air pollution, and ozone layer depletion is the overshoot. That's a more concern, and it must be more concern for the all leader across the world for the betterment, to create the better environment for the human and humanity. But in the case of shortfall, that is going for the more concern, that is in the case of the social foundation, that is the water, food, health, education, income and work, peace and justice, political voice, social equity, gender equality, housing, network and energy. This is the social foundation. We have to be more concerned these two, because without this social foundation, our growth cannot be sustained. So some exercise are there, which way we can do, we can fight together in poverty and all forms of everywhere, in hunger, achieve food security and improve nutrition and promote sustainable agriculture. Number three is to ensure healthy life and promote well-being for all the age. Ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunity for all. Achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. Ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. Ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable and modern energy for all. Promote sustained, inclusive and sustainable growth, economic growth, full and productive employment and decent work for all. Build resilient infrastructure, promote inclusive and sustainable global industrialization and foster innovation. Reduce income inequality within the among country. Make cities and human settlement inclusive, safe and resilient, sustainable. Ensure sustainable consumption and production pattern. Take urgent action to combat climate change and its impact by regulating emissions and promoting development in the renewable energy. Conserve and sustainably use the ocean, seas and marine resources for the sustainable development. Protect, restore and promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystem, sustainable managed forest, combat desertification and halt and reverse land degradation and halt biodiversity loss. Promote peaceful and inclusive society for the sustainable development. Provide access to the justice for all and build effective, accountable and inclusive institution at all level. Strengthen the means of implementation and revitalize the global partnership for the sustainable development. So a close collaboration between science and society, a transition approach involves the cooperation of large number of actors with a different interest and value, which should be integrated if possible. Therefore, if science and the university want to play an active role in sustainable development, they should face a discussion on value and bring this in line with and their scientific understanding. Transdisciplinary cooperation gives rise to new form of knowledge from the contribution of science and other non-academic actors, and knowledge co-productions take place. This knowledge can be different in terms of its importance for the sustainable development. System knowledge, target knowledge, transformation knowledge. So system knowledge require understanding how the environment, economy and social function work. Target knowledge basis on the decision making development and the negotiation goals and vision for sustainable development. As for the transformation knowledge, implementing visions, technology, measures, rules, impact monitoring, culture practice that support a sustainable development. So in the case of sustainable development, we must understand the link between scientific discipline and sustainable development, the system understanding, environmental society, environment, global change, climate, impact of climate change, ecosystem, function, condition, plant, growth, and so on and so forth. System knowledge deals with the target knowledge, deals with the transformation. Knowledge deals with this concept very, very, very elaborately manner. So in these cases, lots of concepts are there and very big concept behind the sustainable development agenda and requirement of sustainable development growth in the globalization, global change, role of science in the sustainable development, educational contact, thematic links between the different subject discipline to the sustainable development value and scientific understanding. So in this concepts, the hangout models is that they are very big models, and I think for the these models may be utilized for the creation of the big partnership goals, partnership for all agenda of the United Nations Sustainable Development 2020 agenda, and that will be the very, very effective. So we have to more concern on the shortfall and overshoot areas of the sustainable development. Thank you very much.
Okay.